Hello students, today we will do poem 2 from class 8th Honeydew book. The name of the poem is Geography Lesson. Dear students, before we start discussing about the poem, first of all, let's discuss about the poet. The poet of this poem is Zulfikar Ghosh, as you can see in the image. So let's discuss about the poet. Dear students, the poet of this poem is Zulfikar Ghosh, who was born on 13th March 1935 and who passed away on 4th April 1979. Students, Zulfikar Ghosh was born in Sialkot, Pakistan. He was a poet and essayist. As he was born in Pakistan, you know very well that he was the native of Pakistan. His works are primarily magical realism, blending fantasy, and harsh realism. His major poems were The Loss of India in 1964 and Jets from Orange in 1967. Here, realism, as you have seen, know that his themes were usually major realism and harsh realism. Here, realism means it is sometimes called naturalism, and it is generally the attempt to represent subject matter truthfully. Truthfully means without artificiality. So, whatever themes he has chosen, he has represented the themes realistically without mingling it with artificial effects. So all the poems, the works which he has presented,
let's start
that are
this beautiful poetry
totally
by Zulfikar Ghosh.
Realistic.
When the jet sprang into the sky, it was clear why the city had developed the way it had. Seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile, there seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard, unplanned and without style when the jet sprang into the sky. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, it was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran, and why the valleys were populated. The logic of geography, that land and water attracted man, was clearly delineated when the jet reached 10,000 feet. When the jet rose 6 miles high, it was clear the earth was round, and that it had more sea than land. But it was difficult to understand that the man on the earth found causes to hate each other, to build walls across cities and to kill. From that height, it was not clear why. If we see the central idea of the poem, we get to know that in this poem, the poet says that when he sees the earth from the sky, he can understand the geographical structure of earth. But he can't understand why people hate each other and why they kill each other. Let's understand the poem stanza-wise. Let's see first stanza. When the jet sprang into the sky, it was clear why the city had developed the way it had. Seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile, there seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard, unplanned and without style, when the jet sprang into the sky. Dear students, if we see first stanza, it is clear that when the poet starts a few hundred feet from the ground, as he go above, he watches that the city had developed without any proper planning or order. It has no uniformity or any logic for its random shape. Here, the poet is looking at the city from a low height. The jet has just taken off and it is above the city. The map measurement from this height is 6 inches to a mile. By repeating the first line at the end of the stanza, the poet creates an effect when we read the same lines at the starting and at the ending. We are reminded of the height of the jet. The most striking theme is the height at which the earth is looked at. In this way, by repeating the height of the jet, we are able to imagine the movement of the jet and the size of the earth at various levels. The poet figures out the inevitability of the way the city developed. Urbanization forced men to build more and more buildings. You know very well that nowadays people want to make every city advance. They want to do urbanization. Everywhere they want to make or build buildings, and that's why they destroy the forest, everything, right? So more and more buildings they are building, and which is the result that the plan and design of the city got lost. It is inevitable. What is inevitability? That means unavoidable thing, or inevitable means that cannot be avoided. So you cannot avoid this because of the forces such as overpopulation or man's greed or shortage of space. Understand? So here, as we see that when the poet goes a few height, that means a few hundred feet from the ground, he watches that the city looks haphazard, means totally disturbed. There is no planning, there is no design. Everywhere building is made in an unplanned way. So here the poet says that this is inevitable, means the man is forced to build the buildings for doing the construction work because of the increasing population, because of the increasing pressure of the population. There is no place, you know very well. So just for creating the residence or home for the people, what the man is doing? The man is cutting the tree, and anywhere, wherever the man is getting place, he is constructing the buildings, right? So now let's see the second stanza. When the jack reached 10,000 feet, it was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran and why the valleys were populated. The logic of geography, that land and water attracted man, was clearly delineated when the jet reached 10,000 feet. Dear students, here 10,000 feet means when we look at the earth from 10,000 feet height, we see only rivers and large territories. Okay, and here valleys are what? The river valleys. We are talking about the river valleys. So in this stanza, the poet says that the logic of geography is that human beings settle in valleys where land and water are available for their survival. Okay, here the poet is observing the earth through a jet which is 10,000 feet above the earth. Okay, so in this stanza, the poet says that when we watch the earth from 10,000 feet above, we watch everywhere what is there? Rivers, valleys are there. So this is the logic, that everywhere people live where they get proper water and they have land. Okay, here delineated means it is described shortly, precisely. Now let's see stanza 3. When the jet rose 6 miles high, it was clear the earth was round and that it had more sea than land. But it was difficult to understand that the man on the earth found causes to hate each other, to build walls across cities and to kill. From that height, it was not clear why. Dear students, as we see this stanza, it is clear that here the poet observes earth from the height of 6 miles. And here he says that when he goes 6 miles high, he is able to see clearly that the earth was round and that it had more sea than land. You might have studied this in social science also, that our earth is mostly covered with water. So when he goes in the 6 miles height, he watches that the earth is mostly covered with sea. Okay, but he here discusses about something very serious which we people never think about. He says that he watches everything about the shape of the earth, how the earth looks, what he is able to see, the relief feature of the earth, everything what is able to see from there. He tells about that. But he discusses that he is not able to see why people hate one another. Right? He finds it difficult to understand that why people hate and why people kill one another. Understand? So it's remain a mystery or secret for the poet at the end, that he is able to see everything about earth, about the relief feature of earth. But he says that it is very difficult to understand why humans hate one another. And this remains a mystery to the poet. So as we see, we find that in the first stanza, the poet watches the earth or the city from the sky. In next stanza, he finds the logic of geography. He finds in third stanza that there is more sea than land. And in the ending lines, he finds the mystery or the secret. And that secret is, he doesn't know why humans hate one another. So here, poet directly criticizes people. He gives a message that we should never hate with one another and we should always spread love, because this is not universally made. This is something which we have to create or we have to make. The love, the compassion, we have to spread. This is not the relief feature. This is the emotional aspect of human life, which can't be seen while going to the heights. We can change this hatred into love by treating everyone equal. Hope you have understood the poem. Thank you very much for watching the video.